be broadcast?
I don't know.
Looks like we are. Yep.
Everyone smile. We'll find that.
All
Hi,
right.
Everyone. Thank you for joining us today. My name is Nick Paddock, and welcome to the University of Cincinnati. It's 7 a.m. here. It's really early. We woke up very, very early to come and speak with you, so we're excited to have you. If you are in our time zone, good morning. If you are across the world and it is evening and you're about to go to bed, good night to you. Yeah. Thanks for attending. So today we have a lot to talk with you about, and we want for you to ask us questions for concerns you have about coming to UC and more. So myself, my name is Nick Paddock. I'm an admissions counselor here. I helped coordinate this with my coworkers and these wonderful students here at UC. So first, to kick this off, we want to congratulate you on all being admitted to the University of Cincinnati. It's extremely exciting. We're very, very proud of you, and we're excited for you all to come here.
Yes. Congratulations.
They all went through the same thing, so they know how you feel right now, right?
Yep.
For today, we're going to talk anywhere from about 30 minutes to an hour, depending on how long it takes to get to our slides and how many questions you have for us. So definitely write in the chat box there with your questions, and we'll do our best to get in touch with you with the answer. If we don't know the answer, we will email you back later, for sure. So as far as our agenda, first we'll introduce ourselves, and then we'll talk about confirming your admission. I know some of you have confirmed your admission, some of you have not, because you're trying to decide what you'd like to do with your future. We'll talk about living on campus, our campus housing, orientation, which starts right before school, registering for your classes, and then how to arrive at UC, right? And what hotels are in the area. And of course, we'll talk about a program or a website called iBearcats Global. iBearcats Global is where all international students will go to complete every step, almost every step, to attend UC and come in the fall. And then we'll open it up to you for more questions. So of course, throughout this, you can ask questions by chatting. And at the very end as well, we'll address most of those questions. So for myself, again, my name is Nick Paddock. I've worked here 3.5 years. I was in domestic admissions for most of that. It's been exciting to work in the international side with you all. My area where I speak with students and work with students is Southeast Asia. So hello to everyone from Southeast Asia. Happy to have you. Fun fact about me is I love Asian food so, so much. And I love very, very spicy hot food. So the hotter, the better. I like it to burn, right? So to go through our students here, we have Hajar, and she's going to fill in the blanks there for her details.
Yes. She's very mysterious and nice. So hi, I'm Hajar. I am from Morocco, from a little town called Moushta, right next to Algeria. Fun. I am an architecture student. I am third year. I actually have been here in the U.S. for 6 years, but it's my third year in UC, so it's really exciting to be here. Some fun facts about me is that I can say hello in 10 languages, which is really cool, right? I'm looking forward to helping you guys with any questions. Oh, and I'm very much involved in campus, forgot about that. I'm involved with student government. I'm involved with the Muslim Student Association, Arab Student Association, the Diversity Student Council, and also the African Student Association. So those are great organizations, and I can't wait for you to come here and be involved. So yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
And Kiki.
Okay, hi, my name is Gigi. I'm from China. I'm a transfer pathway student here, and now I'm a junior in UC. Now I'm majoring in international business. So if you guys have any questions, can add my WeChat or by email me. I'm very glad to help you guys.
Thank you, Kiki, appreciate it. Cameron?
Hi everyone, my name is Cameron. I'm an international student from Uzbekistan, majoring in accounting business. I'm also a first year student here at UC. Fun fact about me is we only have 2 students from Uzbekistan here at UC, which is from one point is amazing because you get to know other people, not just people from my home country. And I also involved on campus. I'm a part of, I guess, an organization. And also I work for UC International Admissions. And I'm super grateful for the staff members here that they hired me. And if you have any questions about my life here, my experience here, how I got here, please don't hesitate. I'll be happy to help you.
Thanks, Cameron. Appreciate it. And Cielo.
Hi, I'm Cielo. I'm from Dagnaburo. My major is finance and accounting with a minor in business analytics. I'm a second year student, but I'm a junior already. My involvement in campus is with LIA Club, that is Latina Selección, for Posts of Ability at UC, and the Linda Finance Club. Fun fact about me is that I had a small monkey as a pet when I was a kid.
You had a monkey?
Yeah.
That's great. Thank you so much. And then we have Duke over here.
Hey, guys. So I'm Duke. I'm from Vietnam, freshman majoring in international business as well. And fun fact about me, I don't like oranges. Yeah, and most of the fruits, I don't like them either. But
that's not fun.
Yeah, I'm pretty, that's just me. And yeah, I'm a part of ICATS as well as IPALS. I'm glad to work with the people here as well.
It's in the video. Thank you very much, dude. All right, so we're going to jump in. So you've all been admitted. You've received an email with your acceptance, and hopefully you've logged into your account to see the admission letter admitting you to your program and to learn more about scholarships you may have received in the process of confirming. So if you've confirmed, thank you so much. If you have not at this point, for this slide, we're sharing the method to confirm your mission. What does it mean to confirm? Essentially, it's you filling out a form stating that you want to come to the University of Cincinnati and be a student. And when you complete the form, you'll pay a $100 fee, right, that will hold your spot as a student at UC. So you'll see under number one, if you want to see the steps on how to confirm, you'd simply put in that URL, that website, and you can see all the images of each step. If you want to jump right to check my status, the number two, you can go right there and log in with your username and PIN to go ahead and confirm. When you get into your account, that bottom image under A, confirmation form and confirmation fee, $100, that's a quick image of what your page will look like. So right there in that red box where it says awaiting, that's where you click to make payment after you complete the form. So if you have any questions about that, please write us and we will answer them for you. Is that process pretty easy for you all?
Mm-hmm. No.
Okay.
Question, when is the deadline to complete the form?
Yeah.
The deadline to complete the form is May 1st. So you have to complete the form and pay the fee no later than May 1st. Okay, that is our hard deadline for sure. And you all did that before
yeah.
May 1st when you came? Correct. Okay. As far as your next step, campus housing. So you do have to confirm first before you can apply to live on our campus. So for this process, I wonder if any of the students want to share how that went. So you can go to our website, uc.edu, Campus Life Housing, and you can look through the communities to see what each style building looks like. We have 11 residence halls, all different styles. We have apartments, the traditional shared room, and then suite style, which is a smaller condensed apartment with a private bathroom. So students have an option to choose of the three options. It's up to them. In addition, you will meet many other students that apply to UC through a portal, right? And you would apply at the housing application on the upper right image. There's a link there in the red box. You'd actually click to sign in and then fill out the application form. When you apply, it's a $50 fee. It's non-refundable. And then a $100 deposit. So the $100 you can get back after your first year when you move out, if there's no damage to your room, of course. So that application opens March 2nd. Right, so the earlier you apply for housing, the more likely you will get the housing option you want. So there is an incentive to confirm early and then apply for your housing early. It is important for you to apply for housing because you all have to live on our campus. So if you live outside of 50 miles from Cincinnati, Ohio, in the United States, you have to live on our campus in one of our residence halls. So each of these students have all lived on our campus, right? Some of us are living on campus. So do you want to talk? You live off campus?
Yeah.
You live off campus now? Anyone live on campus right now?
Yeah, Cameron and me.
You two, do you want to talk about the process you went through to apply for housing and make a match for a roommate, and then where you live now briefly? I guess Duke, do you want to go first?
So I remember a little bit about when I first applied for housing. So like, it's like a portal, it's called like UC Housing. And like you can go in there and log in with your UC 6+2, I think. And then you just like select the housing you want. Like the earlier you sign up for, like the more chance you get to get to that like dorm. And then like, so I choose Daniel's. Like I select like a traditional quad, which like I share room with three other people, and I pick random roommates. But you can also select your roommate as a team, and you and your friends can like choose to where to stay together. But for me, I know no one from Ohio, so I pick random. And yeah, and your roommates can join you later on, and then like there's a brief description about them, and you can use that to see, to know a little bit about your roommates, and you know, maybe you can inbox them and, you know, talk to them more, get to know them. Yeah.
Cameron?
Yeah, I would say I've gone through the same process of application for the housing, and I also picked, like, I didn't pick the like the specific people whom I want to live with. I just picked like random my random roommates. And then also like if you every time reserve your spot as early as possible, like as Duke said, start the application as early as possible so that you will get the chance to choose your desired residence hall. Personally, I live on in Schneider Hall, which is very nice, very quiet place, and I live in suite. I share one bathroom, and like I have my own individual room, and also other my other three roommates. They also have three their individual rooms. My roommates are pretty nice, and the residence hall is really safe. What else?
Is yours a single?
Yeah.
With a bathroom in it?
Yes. Four individual rooms. Like we all share one bathroom, and little like lobby or something, like living room. And yeah, if you like, so you reserve your spot. You've lived for one semester, and then you can move to another residence hall if you want to. If you like, you come to the UC, you meet new people, you made some friends, and then you can move to another residence hall with your friends if there are some spots available.
If I may add something, I know that there's like virtual tours for some of the halls that you could definitely like look at, like the style and your rooms, how they look like. And I think that's really helpful. So I definitely would recommend looking into those.
That's a great point, Hajar. And the virtual tours are on the community page within housing. So if you actually go to the building, like Mary and Spencer, for example, you can click the 360 virtual tour walkthrough. People are asking, where are the residence halls located? So the University of Cincinnati is one large square, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's one large block. So everything within the campus is within a 5 to 10 or 15 minute walk at the most. So you're not crossing through streets in a big urban city like other campuses. So if you are on campus and you have classes over in the engineering building, it won't be more than a 5 to 10 minute walk to your building at the most, right? And after the first year, you don't have to live on campus, right? You can move off campus. And around the University of Cincinnati is a huge community with a lot of rental homes and rental apartments and other communities beyond just the immediate campus, right?
Yeah.
We have some students that live off campus. She lives with a host family, and then some other people live out
I
other
live
places.
In a studio.
You live in a studio.
Yeah.
So do you enjoy living in Cincinnati off campus?
Yes.
How do you feel? Do you feel safe?
Yeah, it's safe and it's really nearby the campus. I only walk to campus in 10 minutes.
You walk to campus from your studio apartment?
Yeah.
Can you have a car when you come to
UC?
Yeah,
I have, but the car is just for like go out on weekend to buy some buy something.
To go out and do things on the weekend?
Yeah.
Can you park on campus?
Yeah, if we need to park on campus, we can like buy a better parking seat for one semester, and it should be like buy it earlier, like in the beginning of the semester, like the first 2 weeks, like that. If you did it very later, it will in the spots. Yeah.
And I will say one thing is that you sometimes don't even need a car. Like, I've lived here without a car for like 3 years, and I definitely was able to omit that option. There's like, even if you live off campus, there's grocery stores, there's like a Target in literally the middle of campus, there's a Kroger right nearby, there's other little stores.
Can you explain what Target is and what Kroger is?
Yeah, absolutely. So they're like stores where you can get groceries, like, you know, everyday items that a student needs or any person needs. So you can find food, you can find like personal items, hygienic items, like all other like needs that you will like probably get from the convenience store or like the grocery store. So you can get them like in a Target or like in Kroger. And these like are literally within walking distances from our campus, which is really great. And that literally omits the option of a car. Like I said, you don't need a car if you don't like have to get it, or if you don't want to drive in the United States. Like, it's very easy to go around. And plus, we have shuttles like that can take you around spaces. There's literally a shuttle that takes you right, picks you up right from the grocery store, and like goes around campus. And there's also like a service that we have at night called Night Ride to make sure that students are safe, that could like give you a ride from your home literally to wherever, like within a mile radius of campus, which is literally like includes, like I said, all the grocery stores, all the convenience stores that you need, different restaurants. So yeah.
And to explain, the shuttle is a large bus. So we have many different routes around campus, and the Night Ride as a van, essentially a van. So we have a van taxi service that's free. Okay, and the shuttle's free as well. Sound good?
Yeah.
Okay, let's move on. Shall we? Let's talk orientation. So orientation starts right before fall semester. So after you confirm, you will also register for orientation. It is from Sunday, August 16th, up till Tuesday, August 18th. On Sunday, it's essentially a welcome to UC, a lot of different activities built in. On Monday, you'll go through all the important sessions, the important topics about UC. You will learn about campus safety, UC services on campus. You'll meet representatives from your college. You'll meet your academic advisor. You'll attend an American Classroom and Culture session. You'll go to an organizational session called iPals, and much more. And then on Tuesday, you'll have more of those sessions. Most importantly, you'll register for the rest of your classes with your academic advisor. Concerning how to register, of course, you can go through the website here, uc.edu/orientation, or you can go through ibearcatsglobal.uc.edu, which we'll talk about in a moment. For orientation, I'd like for you all to share about your experience, and we'll talk about getting to the United States, traveling, but like about orientation, if you could have a couple of you briefly describe what is that, what's the purpose of orientation? And what did you get out of orientation? And then what was it like to meet your advisor for the first time and work with that individual to schedule your courses? Who would like to talk about orientation? Anybody?
Oh, come on, guys. I'm third year. I forgot about all of that.
For the orientations, the first thing is we met the IPALS and the UC International Office will get our information. And then,
and can you explain what IPALS is? IPALS is an organization. Can you explain what it stands for?
It's an organization for the international students.
International partners and leaders. You got it.
International
partners and leaders. Woo!
Okay. we will get, because we have student insurance, and then we will go to the UC Health Center and to get a health scan, and get some students will need to take the immunizations, and then we will go to meet our academic advisors. They will help you to schedule your class for your first semester, and for the any for the like following semesters, you can meet your academic advisor, or you can just go through your catalyst on UC website and schedule your class by yourself. This is all the organization.
Orientation. Is that good for orientation?
Yeah.
Okay, and we'll talk more about registering for classes in a little bit. All right. Thank you very much. So let's talk about coming to the United States. I'm sure that's exciting to come to the United States and also stressful. It can be, right? You know, I know we can talk a lot about the transportation, but do you all want to talk about preparing to move to the United States for school and the steps you need to take to set up your transportation and why you need to set up your transportation from the airport? What were some of the things you did to prepare? So after you confirmed you were coming here, you got all your paperwork done, you're excited. What were some of the things you did?
So for me, before I come to the United States, they're like a, it's like a meeting for students that from Vietnam, like admitted students from Vietnam that kind of go to UC. So we like kind of like meet up together and kind of like get to know our faces and kind of like, there would be like people, like second year or third year students who come back from the United States. They would share some of their experience at UC and kind of like to help us to have more of like understanding what life at UC is about. And like you can ask them questions like what we need to bring and stuff like that. And to me personally, I don't like to bring a lot of stuff with me, but some people I know, they like to bring food from their home country, like you know, noodles. yeah, stuff like that. But to me, I'm not that type of person, so I don't bring that much. But you need to bring clothes for sure, and you know, just look up the weather, like how's it gonna be like in Cincinnati. You know, it's cold, it's snowy. So yeah, bring some winter jacket, stuff like that. And yeah, just make sure you have your paperwork down, like your visa, your passport, I-20, like you put them together, make sure you don't lose them. And you sign up for like airport, what's it called? Airport shuttle?
Yeah, we have it right here on the slide, actually.
Yeah.
So you can see the screenshot and then the link.
Yeah, so you can sign up for them. It's pretty easy to do. And once you get there, they're just going to pick you up right from the airport and bring you to the dorm that you live in at UC. So, like, it's pretty easy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Any other tips about moving to Cincinnati, Ohio?
For me, at that time, I don't know the airport shuttle. So I bought a like temporary SIM card from my country. Just it can be used only 7 days, just 1 week. So once I arrive at US, so I use that SIM card. I can get connect to the internet. So I take Uber.
To
UC. Yeah.
We have Uber.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And Lyft.
Lyft is cheap.
It depends.
I will say one thing, since if you were coming to like fall semester, so when you come here, it's going to be really warm. So I would say like if you want to focus on just getting like all your essentials, like, and not just like winter clothes, so that when you come here, you're going to get well acquainted with like different stores and you can get winter clothes. So yeah, like I would say if you are homesick for food, bring food. Like, he doesn't like fruits, so don't listen to him. I'm just kidding. But like, yeah, like I think like one of the things that I was like very like kind of like wished I got more stuff is actually food. I was really homesick for some of the spices and some of the good stuff that I can hardly find here. So yeah, if you know something like that you really like, yeah, bring it with you. Why not?
As far as, I think food's an important topic, right? You all like to eat, I assume. So food in Cincinnati is, it's diverse. We have some options. I think if you guys want to share about kind of where you go to shop to get the food you want, or if we don't have it at all, you know, in restaurants you might like to eat
that. The market.
So you guys want to share about that? Say hello, or Kiki?
I always go to the camps that is the Asian market. So we can most of the Chinese food I can buy from there. Yeah, I often go there once a week.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I got a car. But I know UC has a shuttle. They will pick students to that market like on Saturday. But we need to sign up through the like a WeChat link, I think.
Yeah.
I never did that. So I know that.
You know,
but I know that.
It's nice as a shuttle.
Yeah.
Yeah. Camp Market's nice. I go there to buy my rice. Anywhere else you shop?
Well,
yeah.
I live with a host family, so pretty much they take me everywhere, and we go out to eat. We like eat Moroccan food, or we eat food from Nepal, or Indian food. I like to eat different types of
yeah,
foods.
That's great.
I think Cincinnati has a great variety of restaurants from all around the world. We have a Peruvian restaurant.
Is it good?
No, I don't like it.
Anything else?
There is for Arab students, there's a little store called Al Medina, and it's like really nice because they have good spices. So, and they also have great food. So, definitely, it's really close. It's like right close to the Kroger, that I was talking about earlier. So you can do like your American grocery shop in there and then, you know, stop by and like pick up some more stuff in the Medina shop. And, my favorite personal restaurant was, I was going to say, the Moroccan restaurant.
It's good.
It's really nice. There's, like,
yeah,
a Moroccan restaurant here, surprisingly. But, like, it's really nice. And it's the whole street is really cute. There's, like, fun stuff to do there. There's, like, a little movie theater that you can go to. So, yeah.
Yeah. Thank you very much. We're going to jump back to housing real quick to talk about the cost of it and what it includes. So if you can see at the bottom of the screen, the cost for housing can range from $11,668 up to $14,214. That just depends on the style of housing you choose. So traditional style, the shared room and the shared bathroom, that's the most affordable option. The most expensive option are the apartments. This also includes your meal plan. So on campus, we have 4 dining halls with unlimited food. So essentially, you can swipe your card as much as you want every day of the week and eat as much as you want. So, and I think the food's pretty good. Do you guys want to talk briefly about the dining? You want to talk about the dining hall?
Yeah, sure.
The 4 options, maybe
There are 4 dining halls across the campus. On the green, which is right downstairs, the Marion Spencer, the new residence hall. Center Court, like, which is literally in the center of our campus. Market Point, and then Cascellar, which is located in TUC. Personally, I, like most of the times, I eat on the green and Santa Court. And I think the food on the green is really good. It is really good. It is not open in the mornings, like early in the morning. So this is why I got breakfast in Center Court. I usually get breakfast at 8 a.m. And On the Green is opens at 10:30. So the dining halls are not like working the same hours. Sometimes On the Green is closing at 8 p.m. and opens at 10:30. Whereas the Center Court like is working till midnight, 12 a.m. Mm-hmm.
Can you talk briefly about, someone asked about what's the menu? So when you go to each dining hall, is it the same exact menu in each dining hall? Or the food options change daily? So can you talk more about, and is it all American food in each dining hall? I think someone's curious. I think a lot of people are actually curious to know what will they eat.
So I have not had like meal plans because like I lived off campus, but I have been snuck in because my friends have like guest swipes. So, and every time I went there, they had like, you know, a different ethnic food. It was really good. So sometimes they'll have like Sushi Friday or like shawarma Thursday. I don't know, like something like that. So it's pretty nice. Like sometimes you'll find different menus in different halls. So I think it's pretty exciting. So you get to like eat different foods. But I think there's also like a consistent like bars for like, you know, like I don't know,
pizza
the
like
salad bar or a pizza bar or something
good.
Like that. That if you, yeah, exactly. So if you're not like, if you just want to have like comfort food, it's definitely good for you.
And many of the colleges have a cafe in the building.
Yeah.
Yep.
So you can also utilize your Bearcat card there, your meal plan card, and receive a breakfast, lunch, or dinner. It's more of a set item,
mm-hmm.
right? But there are food options within most of the buildings as well.
Yeah. There's a, I forgot to mention, there's a stadium view also where you can get to go, like burgers, fries.
Yeah.
You can just swipe your Bearcat card and then get a burger or and fries like or pizza and then just go whatever you want.
And beyond the UC dining options, we have three Starbucks, right?
Yeah,
three Starbucks on campus. So I know that Kiki loves the Starbucks the most.
Yeah.
She always has Starbucks. And then we have other restaurants on campus that you have to pay. It's not part of your swipe card. You have to pay from your own bank account for that type of food and for that Starbucks as well, right?
Yeah. And I will say one thing. It's a lot of restaurants on campus will take your Bearcat card. So you can put actual money to your Bearcat card, like a kind of like a Visa card or a bank card. So you can like swipe it. If you have like some Bearcat cash or Bearcat money, and they'll take it.
Yeah. And we did have someone ask if you can live off campus your first year. It is required that you live on campus your first year for all incoming students that are outside of 50 miles from Cincinnati, Ohio. We do make exceptions for students on a case-by-case basis. So if you would like to email me, I'll give you my email at the end of the presentation. You can email me and I will chat with you about why you want to live off campus, and possibly if you have family here, or if you have something set up. Typically, it's if you have a family member that lives in Cincinnati, Ohio, and you can move in with that family member. That's typically the only exception. But of course, I'll give my email at the end, okay? Or actually,
how about the students here over 21 years old?
Students over 21 don't have to live on campus. If you're a transfer student and this is your second year of college or third year of college, you don't have to live on campus. If it's your first year going to college, you have to live here on campus, okay?
Unless you have family
here.
And one thing,
if
you're wondering how you're going to pay with your Bearcat card, every semester you will get $150 in your Bearcat card that you can spend on Starbucks or off campus. Yeah. That only the places that accept the Bearcat card. Whenever you go to the to these places, you will see like that they
accept the Bearcat.
Yeah, they accept the Bearcat. They're gonna write it somewhere, and you can spend your money from a Bearcat there. And also, you can buy like you can spend whatever you want.
And just to clarify, that comes with the meal plan.
Yes.
It's not
mm-hmm.
like every student on UC gets $150. It's like with the meal plans, that
mm-hmm.
comes like a little bit of money. So.
Thank you, everyone. Okay, we're gonna move on to banking because that's an important part, right? Banking,
yes.
And then if your family visits or you have relatives visit, kind of where they can stay around campus. Okay, so here at UC we have a bank on campus. It's called PNC Bank. I have a screenshot here on the screen. You're welcome to go to that website to look further into that option. So I know that's important, right?
Mm-hmm.
You then want to share about that process of setting up an account. Has anyone done that?
It's pretty easy when you come in. During my orientation, they asked me if I wanted to set up an account with PNC. I had already like been here in the U.S. longer, so I already like had a different bank affiliation, but like they'll be there for you. So it's very easy process. You just have to have your passport, which, you know, if you're in orientation, you have to have on you. So it's pretty easy. You just have to have your passport, which is like a form of identification, and like they'll be able to assist you further. And I think that like, I'm not sure about the exact details about like deposits and stuff. I'll let you guys speak about it if you know, but I'm pretty sure it's like,
I don't think you have to put a deposit.
You can like cash deposit.
Yeah, like you know the first time they when you sign up.
You don't have to put
yeah,
anybody
you don't have to.
The first time at all.
Yeah, I didn't want to like give false information, but yeah, that was like pretty sure like they'll open the bank account for you, and it's pretty easy because we have like a lot of ATMs around the automatic machines, which is really another convenient thing. So if you need cash, like it's pretty like
they're working 24/7.
Yeah. So yeah.
Okay, what about hotels in the area? I know we talk about where do people stay when they come to Cincinnati, Ohio. So I put up here some hotel options. There's three right around campus that are convenient. Of course, we have Airbnb as another option if you're looking for to live, stay in someone's apartment or home. Yeah, so there's a lot of options in Cincinnati for hotels. There's probably over 40. But there's three hotels right next to campus for
yeah.
your family's convenience.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Before coming here, I personally stayed in Kingsgate Hotel, which is really
yeah.
close to our campus.
Okay. Well, we're going to move on to some important stuff. Oh. Looks like my tabs are a little removed. I'm sorry about that. So we're going to talk about the financial support documents you have to submit, your I-20 form you have to submit, CVIS fee, visa, paying your application fee, all that fun stuff. So we'll jump in, and I'm going to have all the students support me through this, right? So iBearcatsGlobal.uc.edu is where you're going to go to complete these steps. So once you're admitted to UC, you'll then have to log in to confirm. Once you confirm to UC, 72 hours after you confirm and pay the $100 fee, you'll receive a new email from UC with a new username and a new password, essentially, a new PIN. That is for iBearcatsGlobal.uc.edu, this slide right here. When you get that new password, you can click the link to go to this website. And then on the right side, you'll see limited services. That's the link you will click to log in. Okay, so when once you log in, you see a lot of information. There are six tabs you can select. You have to start with tab one and work your way through, right? And complete all the steps in each tab. So this is going to be your portal where you kind of get everything organized, get everything checked off, and get everything taken care of. Let's see. A really important first step is your I-20 form and financial documents, right?
Yeah.
And this is to ensure that your family has the financial income to support and pay for your tuition, your housing on campus, your dining plan, and your books and fees, okay? And I'd like for you all to, does anyone want to share about that process of filling out that paper form you received and then scanning all your documents with your parents? And then uploading them in the system. It's a really, is it, I feel like there's a lot of detail there.
I will say, I think you can have up to, I know this off the top of my head, you can have up to five sponsors. So if like, it's a really large amount of money and it's very understandable. So if you have different like families, like if you're requiring like sponsorship from your parents, like so you can say like your dad, your mom, maybe like, know, an older sibling or like a grandparent or like, you know, I don't know, a godparent, someone who could like, you know, could show that they have financial aid to support you, they could definitely split that amount up to five sponsors. I know that for sure. And you do need to finish this like as early as possible so that they can email you your I-20 in order for you to get your visa. Because when you're asking for a visa, like to come to the United States, they ask you for the I-20. And that's the proof of like the only proof, not even like your acceptance letter, but like your I-20 is the proof of you coming or like having an acceptance in an American university, which basically helps them grant you the visa to come here. So it's very important to get that or like process as early as possible. And there is a checklist that you that like they also have it in a yeah. So you can like basically check it as soon as you're done with it. And it just helps you keep in track. Yeah.
And once you submit all that information, you'll hear back from our international services office
mm-hmm.
With approval, hopefully,
mm-hmm.
or they might have follow-up questions for you. Concerning the next step in there, paying your CVIS fee and whatnot, do you want to talk about that?
I know for the CVIS, I'm not sure about the CVIS fee, but I know the CVIS number is on your I-20. Once you get that, that is like a number that you need to share with your parent or give them a copy of your I-20 because that's the way that you are able, they're able to send you money or you're able to receive money in the United States. So it's a very important number that you definitely have to share with your parents. I'm not sure about the fee.
I think it's about $200.
Okay.
I remember if you like leave US more than 5 months, you need to like pay the service fee.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So for, let's see, there's the service fee, sorry. The fee is $350. Okay. Now we know. Sorry. So I should say, once you get through each step, you do have to hit submit and complete each step in order to move to the next tab, tab two, tab three,
yeah.
tab four. So we keep you organized. For tab planning your arrival, we talked about that a bit as far as how to plan to move to Cincinnati, Ohio, and then how to set up your transportation from the airport to campus. And then review and register for required UC events. This is when you're going to be signing up for your orientation. We call Bearcats Bound Orientation. So you hear the word Bearcat a lot. That's our mascot. A Bearcat is a small, cute little animal. It's like a cat and a bear combined. And we've turned that into our mascot. So he's all over campus. Our mascot's all over campus running around. And we have a lot of fun with that person. As far as signing up for Bearcats Bound Orientation, you do need to register for that. It is a requirement for you to come here and be a part of orientation before school starts in the fall. You cannot skip orientation. It's essential that you're here with all the other international students, meeting other students on campus and signing up for your classes and being kind of acquainted with how things work at the University of Cincinnati. And then you will review the UC student health insurance policy. Did any of you do that step? The health policy step?
Yeah, so you have
to review that.
You just review it, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You also, when you come in, you have to do immunizations.
Yeah.
So you have to do that as soon as possible when you come to campus.
You do that back home or here at UC?
You can do it here too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you did that back home, but you're not required to do that here.
You
if
you bring paperwork?
Yes, you
mm-hmm.
have to fill a lot. I forgot the, how's that called?
Immunization record?
Yes, immunization
form.
Record form.
Mm-hmm.
If you fill this out and everything is like, you have done everything, you show this paper to staff members here who work for University Health Services, then you're good to go.
Okay.
And the one thing I want to add is that you
talk up.
Okay. The students like insurance, health insurance can cover the HPV immunization.
Mm-hmm.
So like girls can go to the health center to get the HPV immunization for free.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's good.
Yeah, right on our own campus we have our medical offices. All right, and then immigration review. We provide mandatory personal information, immigration document upload, get your schedule and health screening appointment, and the I-94 entry record upload. So you'll need to go through each of those steps as well after you finish the first four tabs. And lastly, there's more resources for you as an international student because there's lots to learn about this process before you come to Cincinnati, Ohio, to UC. All right?
I know it's a lot of like steps, but it's very helpful and it's very like self-explanatory. Like once you're in the process, like it becomes very clear. It becomes like it answers your questions. It's very like elaborated so that you don't have a lot of questions like, or you're not left confused. So this definitely like the iBearcats Global website was so helpful to me like coming to UC, and I'm pretty sure it will definitely do a great job helping you prepare to come to UC.
Thank you, Ajar.
Yeah.
Anything else you guys want to add? Okay, so now we're going to move on to questions. And we had a great question about working on campus. And I did make a slide for it, so we'll talk about it now. The University of Cincinnati is known for career experience, essentially. So we have cooperative education, which we call co-op. For short, and also internships. We also have research, performance, community involvement, a lot of different options to gain professional experience. The most common and most popular are co-ops and internships. So for an internship, you can begin internships your first year at UC, your first semester if you'd like. You can work up to 20 hours per semester or per week per per semester, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can't work more than 20 hours legally, and you can do one semester per semester for the entire 4 years. It's really up to you and what fits into your schedule. Most internships are not paid in the United States. Some are. It depends where you work. You can work on campus. A lot of our international students like to work on campus. It works with their schedule, their classroom schedule. They learn a lot of professional skills. They can network on campus. And also, on their downtime while they're working, they can do homework and prepare for class. All of these students here, they all work for the International Admissions Office. So they enjoy it. We love having them. They're wonderful people. But there are other offices on campus students can work. And in addition to that, Cooperative Education Co-op, like I said, is very unique. It started at the University of Cincinnati. It's offered in the College of Engineering and Applied Science. They do five semesters of work over 5 years. The College of Design, Architecture, Art, and Planning, we call it DAP. They do typically all majors in DAP, do five semesters of co-op. And the Linder College of Business, they have an optional co-op. So you don't have to do it if you don't want to. Within that college, typically companies call those co-op experiences internships. So within the business college, the word changes back and forth from co-op to internship. When you co-op at UC, it always starts your second year if you choose to co-op in business or if you're required to in engineering or DAP arts, it will start your second year. When you co-op, it can be anywhere in the United States mm-hmm. or the world, actually.
Yeah.
It's an exciting opportunity. So your second semester of your second year, you'll actually leave school and go work full-time for the whole semester. You do not pay tuition when you're on co-op, and you make an income, right? You
yeah.
actually get paid. You get paid
about
$10,000 per co-op. That's the average between all of our students at UC. So if you do five co-ops, do the math, you make about $50,000 while you're a student at the University of Cincinnati. So it's a great opportunity to gain professional experience, build your resume, fall in love with your career path, and also gain income, right, to help pay for your tuition or pay for all the McDonald's you want to eat or Starbucks you want to eat. It's really up to you. For co-ops and internships, our staff on campus organize those opportunities for students. So all a student has to do is get online at handshake.com, log in, and they can see a list of the opportunities that fall within what they're looking for. So it takes the stress out of finding a job. For international students, it can be tricky because you can only do three co-ops, right, in the United States because of the hours.
Yeah.
And then
you
don't want to reduce your OPT.
You work 2 years as an international student. But if you're in engineering, you work three. You have 3 years to work in because they have five co-ops.
STEM. Yeah, mm-hmm. It depends on like the length of your program, and
yeah.
So they look at that. So when you're doing, they give you like the amount of time of CPT based on your co-ops. So don't like definitely don't worry about that. I will say also that we have like a like organized like website called Paul, where like a lot of employers will like post like jobs, so you don't like have to go and find the job yourself. We also have career fairs on campus where employers will come to you here, and all you have to do is just present yourself with a resume and like talk to them, and they can like offer you an internship or a co-op. So like when it comes to like career, UC is definitely like one of the greatest universities for that. And one of the benefits that I will say, like I have friends who were in architecture, and upon completing their first co-op, they realized like, oh, this is not for me. This is not what I want to do. So it kind of like saves you from having to like complete a whole degree and then realizing when you go to the workforce, oh, this is not what I want to do. So it's a really amazing opportunity to kind of figure out like, this is like, finally, like this is really what it looks like when I graduate, this is what it's going to be. And you really kind of just decide based on that. So it's a great opportunity other than just gaining money and professional growth. Yeah.
And almost all of our students do co-op or internships on the entire university. So it is a normal experience. It's really fun to talk with students about what they're doing in the classroom and outside mm-hmm. the classroom as well. Ciela wanted to add more about the duration of your co-ops and what you and your pathway after college.
I think it's the opposite that you and you. So that your advisor recommends you to do, if you're like an engineer, you have to do five. So he recommends you, or she is, to do three co-ops in the US.
and then the other two outside of the US. So you don't use all your time. But they give you, I think, 2 years. And
after you graduate?
Yeah, like they give you, as an international student, the US government gives you 2 years, I think, to work.
And then for STEM, it's 3.
Yeah.
I think so.
I'm not
sure. Yeah, so typically our international students will do 3 co-ops here in the United States and then 2 back in their home country or another country that they find an opportunity for.
They have like information stations about CPT and OPT, and also you can talk to your advisor and she will help you with that.
Yeah, your academic advisor in your college is a resource for you from the day you start at orientation until you finish. You might have different advisors every year, but they'll help keep you on track to register for the right classes. If you want to earn a minor or certificate or double major, they'll help organize your schedule so you can pursue those opportunities. And then they'll talk to you about professional development, what you want to do for your internships, mm-hmm. co-ops here in Cincinnati and across the country and internationally.
And also your career coach also can help you with like internship opportunities, co-op. If you have any questions about your majors, your specific major, and the jobs like that you want to apply to, you can talk to your career coach as well. Every single major has its own career coach.
Thank you.
Do you have any idea about the accelerated engineering?
Yeah, as far as I had someone ask about the health insurance fee, I asked Kiki, and she said it's about under $200
per year. Yeah.
Okay. So we can look into that for you as well. As far as the engineering accelerated program, when you apply to UC and are admitted to engineering, if you have a high enough ACT or SAT and GPA, and you meet requirements that are outlined on the engineering website, you can apply for the accelerated program. So your fifth year, the last year of the engineering program would be your first year of graduate school. So you combine your undergraduate and graduate degree that fifth year, and then your sixth year is your second year of your graduate degree. So you've kind of shortened up getting an undergraduate degree in 5 years and then a graduate degree in 2 years from 7 years total to 6 years. Right, so if you go to our website and search engineering and type in accelerated, they'll have more of the requirements for students to be admitted to that program. It's an amazing thing. A lot of students take that pathway. Can you all do 5 co-ops in the US? I think we answered that. You can do 5 co-ops, but it will shorten your OPT if you do them all in the US, right? It'll shorten just a little bit. Okay. Do you have any other questions, Maria?
Nope. We got like 5 minutes left.
Okay. Well, I think in closing, I think we've covered a lot of information. I will go to this slide here. This is our thank you slide. There are our names and then our emails. I've got mine. If you have questions about your admission letter, what program you're admitted to, scholarships, or very technical things about iBearcats Global, you're welcome to email me and I will get you the answer. If you want to talk to any of the students here further about their experience being admitted to UC, scholarships, what else? Filling out the iBearcats Global, coming to Cincinnati, Ohio.
Which clubs or organizations?
Which organizations to join? Anything at all about the campus experience or being a UC student, please email them. They're wonderful. They will write you back, right? They'll be friends with you when you move here, probably. They're the nicest people, right? So, yeah.
We'll help you introduce other people as well.
Yeah, thank you.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because I think connections are powerful here.
Do you all have anything to add at the end? Do you want to say anything to these admitted students? We have 22 still watching, which is wonderful. Thank you for staying with us for this hour.
Good.
Anything in closing you want to say?
Well, guys,
go UC.
I don't know. I was thinking, well, my biggest tip is just if you don't know anything, ask.
Just
ask. Yeah,
ask
is like a really
just
helpful thing. But it sounds simple, but it's really helpful. Like, ask. Like, from going to the airport to coming here, like, knowing if you don't know anything, ask. Ask the people who work there. If you go to UC, you don't know anything, ask the staff, ask the employee, like, it will give you the answer, you know, just seek.
Yes.
Yeah, most people in Cincinnati are very friendly to an extent. So like they'll help you like if you ask, you know, for help, or if they know that you're not from here, they're more than happy to help you. So yeah.
Just to say, when you leave your home country alone, the friends is your family.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We will post this this live video. We'll save it and we'll post it at the UC International YouTube account or page, so that you can see it again. You can share it with your friends, show your parents.
Yeah.
Anything else? We're good.
Yes.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
All right. See you later. Take care. How do I sign out? I don't even know. Do we know?
Just exit the tab.
Oops. Yeah, I think you have to close it out on the MacBook.
Oh.
Yeah. So we're still live.
Yeah.
Now we need breakfast.
Oh.
So you go to the bottom.